Yung Shue Tau was a historical gathering point in front of Tin Ho Temple in Yomate. Since 1950s, it was one of the most bustling places with noise and excitement. In every evening, people live nearby would assemble under the big banyan tree, which has lived for hundreds of years. Jugglers, fortune tellers, peddlers, and singers began their business when night fell. The street was immersed in the neon light, laughter and singing, which marked a flourishing and gorgeous paradise on earth, a symbol of folk life and leisure. If you walk along the temple street ahead to the Yung Shue Tau, it appears to be a famous tourist attraction nowadays. When you listen carefully to the language of the passersby, you will find that most of them are tourists. However, the prosperous scene of a grassroots nightclub has declined. Yung Shue Tau was the open stage for amateur Cantonese opera performers in 1950s and choral singing karaoke in 1990s. However, at present, only two pop song groups and one Cantonese opera group remains in a lonesome corner near Yung Shue Tau. Along with some fortune tellers, the store of the singing group was only shielded by a piece of shabby clothes of red, white, and blue. When we watch the place from far, it looks like an old woman who has drifted her whole life. However, after we close up, we can hear the laughter and singing in the store, where people sit around the tables, which make the small space crowded. When we first stepped into the shed timidly, a middle-aged woman came to greet us with a smile. All around were mostly elder men who stared at us with curiosity and kindness. An electronic organ, a microphone, some lights constituted all the equipments of the group. Four female singers, whose ages were among 20 to 40, were busily chatting with the guests and occasionally came to the center singing a song. If the guest wants to sing, he should find a song in the thick songbooks. The book looks just like some ancient heirloom, with the content of full lyrics and scores. We spent 10 minutes poring over the books, but finally found that those songs seemed so strange and far to us, among which the only one I know to sing is Don't Pick the Roadside Wildflowers.
他有唱歌，即係佢都唱歌，即係佢都冇做其他嘢。係咪想做歌星啊？佢喜歡唱歌。
佢喜歡唱歌。即係電視唔係都有嗰啲節目去唱歌嗰啲，
係比賽嗰啲唔去啊？
佢唔會去，
佢怕醜。
我女都算唔怕醜，不過佢嘅經驗仲未夠，未去到比賽嗰個地步。但係翻屋企都會練嘅。佢唱歌得㗎，不過佢比較細膽啲。誒，
保齡金嗰啲。
佢誒80年代嘅歌啦，同埋
因為而家都有啲
新嘅歌，
其實。
但係
你自己
係
咪中意？
我自己中意唱歌，我中意唱舊歌。 例如鄧麗君嗰啲啊，月亮代表我的心啊，就徐小鳳嗰啲啊，80年代嗰啲歌咧，都啱我唱。再上啲咧就50年代、60年代啦，五音啊，吹平啊，賠率嗰啲。你都唔識，你未出世啊！
The youngsters passing by usually have few comments on the singing groups. Some of them thought they are the elders' game, which has no relationship to the younger generation's life. Some thought that it is not qualified to be considered as a cultural phenomenon. While some college students respected the group and hoped that they can keep singing, because this is a symbol of Hong Kong local culture. But most of the young people expressed that they had no intention to walk in the shed, sitting and singing with the elders. Some of the tourists from mainland China will get closer to the group curiously. They are always listening, but seldom singing by themselves. Foreigners felt interested in the group. They will stand in the distance and keep watching.
有啲屯門咧、青衣咧、大埔咧、上水咧、元朗咧都出嚟玩嘅。
The elder guests lived in different regions. Even those are living in Shuang Shui, Tuen Mun, and Zhuang Guan O also arrived in time every evening. They enjoy the atmosphere here where people can sing on the stage and having fun with others. They make friends here, help the singers to organize and treat the newcomers, not just because it is cheap to sing here, but they treat everyone under the shed as companions. The little shed seems to be their spiritual shield for the old men who still reminisce the old times. The city of Hong Kong has changed a lot, which was witnessed by all the elders and the old banyan tree. People come and leave, moved from the old house to some remote regions. But the singing store in Yung Shue Tau held the happy memories of the former residents in the neighborhood. Elder people were marginalized in Hong Kong society. They lingered every day in the street garden, went to watch morning film along in the cinema. They can't call a crowd of friends to KTV like us. Where are their best days? It lingered in the open singing stores, where voice of Choi Siu-Fong and Deng Lei-Guan are still as sweet as their memories.
呢啲係我哋嘅特色嚟嘅文化特色，佢話要個保留，
係
啊，係啊，係啊。佢話佢細佬哥唔細個已經跟佢媽咧，跟佢爸爸嚟睇㗎啦。佢話唔好希望執咗佢，保留翻呢個特色喺度。
The neon lights and songs in Yung Shue Tau were considered as symbols of an old Hong Kong. The younger generation still comes to the fortune tellers to discover their lives through the advice of the elder generation. But they will not share and understand happiness with them anymore. Thank you.